Hey guys, it's Bri. Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to be talking about my last final that I did for my draping class. And for my final, basically, I created an outfit that was inspired by the movie Sylvie's Love, which Tessa Thompson played in, and I created a six look collection which was inspired by her character. So in this video, I'm gonna go over just like some parts of my presentation that I did, and it'll show like my mood board and my inspiration board, the details, like design details and all that stuff. So yeah, if you're not subscribed yet, definitely subscribe to my channel and like this video, because I know you're gonna like it anyway. And comment at the end of this video, what was your favorite part, or maybe like what design out of the collection you think was your favorite. So yeah, without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, so to start off, I'm just gonna talk about my first initial pages, which are also, if I'm looking to the side, I'm looking at my presentation, that's why. But so the first three pages I had were my mood board, my design details, and my just like current trends and like trends that follow with like what I was trying to do. So for her jacket, I wanted it to be like very flowy and like long and just very voluminous. So most of the jackets I researched and looked up were like opera jackets, baby doll jackets, just like trench coats, jackets that were very like long and had like voluminous style details to them. So that was one aspect that I knew I definitely wanted to do. And also in the movie, I just tried to focus in on like the different colors that she always was wearing and just what I thought would look best on her. Initially I wanted to do blue and orange, but I couldn't find a good like wool fabric that I thought would go well with like the idea I had. So I ended up switching to purple and white because I found this like really amazing fabric, and once I saw it, I was like, yes, I need to buy this fabric, because it was like it fits so well with like what I was trying to do. So I bought that fabric, and then later down the line, which you'll see in the process, like in some of my other clips, I ended up not having enough for the whole jacket in that fabric, so I had to buy a counter fabric as well, and it ended up coming out really well with like what I was trying to do. So yeah, I started off initially researching, and then from there I did some sketches. I can show you guys my slide of my initial sketches, and then from there I really just because I had the fabric also already, so I just started to draw out the final illustration as well as the other five designs that had to go in the collection. So I tried to make each of them really different, but the one that I was actually making it come to life was probably my favorite one. But I also do like the blue one as well, which is the one next to the one I ended up making. But yeah, it was really fun to make, and I really enjoyed this like whole collection that I drew out. And I may end up making more of the outfits that were in this initial collection. So if you guys want me to do that, I'll definitely do that. And comment below if that's something you guys would be interested in seeing. Okay, so now talking more about the prototype and the final garment. So basically, the prototype was really good. It came out really well. I was really happy with like the final result of it. I just had to make a few like fit changes, which you'll probably hear in like a couple of my videos that I have, which will be in this. Came out really well, but I had to make a few adjustments, which I did in the pattern. And then when I did the final, it was so nice. Like the way it came out, I was so happy with the final result. And I think the counter fabric I ended up picking actually worked really well, so I'm glad about that too. So yeah. It was a long process. It was like, I'm about to add up the hours and like put it at the bottom somewhere, but like it was a long process. But I really enjoyed it, and I really hope that When I tag like Tessa Thompson and like the other actors and the director, hopefully they'll see this and they'll like it too, because that'd be really like amazing if I got noticed by them and I got their reaction of like how they liked it, like the final piece and everything. So yeah, that's the whole explanation basically. So the rest of the video is really just gonna be like my final design process, and then you'll see the final coat. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and definitely stay to the end so you can see the final result. And if you guys have any other like requests for other kind of videos you want me to do, comment below, because I'll definitely like look into them and like look into doing them, because I want to try to do like different creative fashion and self-care and like beauty, hair, mainly fashion though. I just want to do like all kinds of fun videos for you guys. So yes, that's it. This is the end of the video. I hope you guys, well, not the end, this is the end of me talking, but I hope you guys enjoy this video, and yeah, that's it. Play the next clip. Okay guys, so hopefully my mic works in this, but this is the next step I'm doing. So basically for my jacket, I'm doing an inner lining so that the jacket is warm. So I have this fleece inner lining, which is going to be in between the lining and the base fabric, which is this wool. So right now I'm sewing all the fleece to the base fabric, so that I can just sew everything together and it'll be really cohesive. So yeah, this is my base. No, this is my base. This is my inner lining, just so that it can stay warm, because this is supposed to be like a warm jacket worn like winter, fall season. So yeah, this is how it's looking so far. I'm really happy with how it's turning out so far and everything. So next thing you guys see will probably be maybe like me putting it together with the skirt and everything. Okay, so this is how it looks right now. I'm about to go to sleep and then finish this on Monday morning, because I have to work early in the morning, so I'm gonna finish this on Monday. But yeah, this is where we're at. I attached the skirt to the bodice, the sleeves and the fur, and the interlining. All I have to do now is do the placket, the
the facing and the lining, the inside, like the outer lining basically, and then the hem, and then we're done. So this is where I'm leaving you guys, and I'll see you on Monday.
Just wanted to show you guys how it looks on this mannequin. But yes, this is the final coat. She looks real cute in this corner. But yeah, I hope you guys really did enjoy this video, and I'm glad that you guys are still a part of this journey with me. And definitely remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next week, or in 2 weeks, because I'm doing bi-weekly. So yeah, bye guys.